I've been incredibly depressed lately. Especially this past week, but especially since last night. My self-esteem has been in the crapper. And some of why I've been just saying it like it is because I'm just sort of in this mindset of, well, what else do I have to lose? And when I think about things logically and rationally, I know that, I'm lucky to have the things that I have. Very. Or I should say, I'm very fortunate to have the things that I have. Because luck, that's a... just the concept of luck is a little bit iffy, so... But I've been having a ton of suicidal ideations lately. It's been just this thing of, and this too shall pass, and this too shall pass, and this too shall pass. I put far too much importance on my physical appearance. Far too much. Far, 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 far too much. Some of it, though, is because I don't feel I'll probably ever be in a relationship again. On the sexual side, I haven't really... I can count on one hand the amount of times I've climaxed with another person. The panic will kick in and just pretty much destroy any of that. I can enjoy servicing someone, but then they're gonna feel like they're not doing a good enough of a job if they can't get me off. And I love cuddling. I love cuddling and kissing and holding and showing affection in public and holding hands and all of that sort of thing. I love that. But I can't imagine that would be enough for someone. And when I'm alone, I can have a lot of climaxes, more than most people. You know, I've been known to have 5 in a day, you know, but so some of me has done this thing of, well, you know, since I'm not going to be with anyone, I might as well just try to enjoy myself. Which is somewhat where the crux of the gaining thing. The crux of my enjoyment of being heavy. And I know that there's definitely a number of others that can enjoy that sort of thing, but if I'm not going to be with people, and I'm not going to be able to climax with people, then I might as well focus on something that gets me off, you know? And from 2013 to the beginning of this year, I kind of had it in my head, well, I've never been with a woman. Maybe the problem with me not being able to climax has to do with... this is the thing that always went through my head. This is why I wondered whether I'm bi or something like that, even though I hardly have attractions to women at all. I mean, it's almost non-existent, but there's a tiny hint of it that's there. And I'd think, you know, maybe that's the thing. I've never been with a woman. Maybe a woman might be able to maybe there'll be some sort of compatibility that allows me to climax with someone. You know? But I wrote that off. I wrote that off. And just consider myself gay. Primarily out of a lot of the shit that a lot of these feminists will say, especially people like Gussie Jives. And I know that there's a number of other people like who think this way, where if you... It doesn't matter how consensual the sex is. A woman can later decide that she didn't like the sex, and can decide that she didn't really want the sex, and therefore can call it rape, you know, after the fact. And there's this idea that that's... That would be justified. And I'm like, no. No, I've never heard of a guy ever doing that to someone ever. And so I'm just not going to chance it. I'm not even going to fathom it. I'm not even going to think about it. Of course, I do think about it once in a while, but... So... Anyway, the reason why I'm going off about, you know, the weight gain thing is because I had a health scare once last week and once last night, where I was laughing a lot and suddenly, you know, out of this massive amount of laughing, I suddenly had a massive tightness in my chest that felt like someone was pushing on my chest. And nervousness. And last week when it happened, I had a little bit of lightheadedness when it happened. And that's not a good thing at all. And I'm sure many of you will be like, well, I told you so. You should have known better. Yeah, I should have. I should have. I shouldn't have put sexual-oriented things over my health. Even though... I have no visual self-esteem when I was thinner because I had all this extra skin with no way to fix it unless I suddenly made a lot of money and could have cosmetic surgery to remove the extra skin. But that's not really possible, you know. That's just not in the cards. So... But things that have had me so down, though, besides, I should finish what I was saying. So last night, after that happened, I went to the emergency room. Went to St. Joseph Medical Center, was there for about 6 hours. They did an EKG, perfect results, no problems. They did a number of heart enzyme tests, no problems. Thyroid tests, no problems. Whole bunch of tests, no problems. Everything was fine. So, I was thankful for that, but I still am going to have to radically change my lifestyle. Radically. I don't want to go back to being skinny, but I'm going to have to go back to the way my diet was between 2010 and 2013 and eat more of those kinds of foods, a lot more vegetables, you know, cutting way back on cheese, cutting way back on a lot of the dairy, just a whole bunch of things, whole shit ton of things. But instead of like I did then, where I was eating like a bird, you know, eat decently, but make sure it's decent food. You know, no more of this constant mac and cheese with other things mixed into it, you know, which is what I've been doing a lot of lately. And, I've been keeping up on my glucose levels. Those have been fine. I've been keeping up on my blood pressure. That's been fine. But my cholesterol, I haven't had it checked since last year, and I've gained a shit ton of weight this year through a lot of these fatty foods, and I'm sure that my cholesterol level is sky high. So... Yeah, I should have known better. Again, I shouldn't have put sexual things or this visual side of self-esteem over my health. But the other parts of my self-esteem have been in the crapper, because I used to be such a proficient, is that the word? Prolific, which is the right word? Musician. I mean, if I put my mind to it, I could put out 2 songs in a night. I mean, completed songs. Produced, fully produced. From start to finish, I could put out a couple songs in a night. And now, I haven't had the inspiration for any of that. From 2011 to 2013, I was on this medication called Zyprexa, and a lot of people will talk about how, oh, street drugs ruin my life, and it's street drugs that ruins people's lives. No, sometimes pharmaceutical drugs ruin people's lives, even the ones that are prescribed to you. Not talking about when people have a drug addiction to, you know, Oxy or something like that. You know, Zyprexa just fucked me up. I'm still recovering from a lot of what that did. It messed up my memory pretty bad. And, you know, it may have stopped my panic and some of the reasons for the panic, but it kind of destroyed everything else. So now, you know, I just don't seem to have the inspiration to finish a song. Of course, back then, when I would write songs, I was always in this mindset of, oh, I can make it. I can make it. I could probably make it big in some way. And now I'm like, oh, there's no chance of that. People don't want to hear stuff that's very different. People don't want to hear odd time signatures. People don't want to hear weird progressions. They want something that's familiar. They want something that they know. Just a slight twist on something that they know. That's just kind of how it is. And so, you know, it's kind of hard to want to make music knowing that it's never going to go anywhere, you know. And then there's bands. This area sucks for music. I mean, it sucks for music. It's all about metal. And if you like metal, this is a great area, you know? Great! If you like metal, hey, you should come to this area and check out the live band scene, you know? But if that's not your scene, if that's not your thing, yeah, this area sucks. It sucks. All the bands want screamers and growlers. Done Craigslist so much here. And then the times that I do find a band that's not that sound, I try out for it. I send them an email. Hey, I've put these vocals on your song, because that's how they'll do it. They'll leave a link to an MP3 or a SoundCloud or something like that, and I'll put some vocal line on top of it, and I send it. Oh, we already have someone. All right. After have that happen several times, I'm just like, okay, well, you know. So, you know, I just, but especially after what happened last night, self-esteem is in the crapper. In a year, I'll probably be fugly. This is going to sound weird, but when you see me wearing shirts all the time, that doesn't mean I'm happy. I'll just put it that way. One of the things that's been uplifting for me is that my mother was willing to, on her visa, give me a loan. It's going to take me probably close to a year to pay it off to get this camera. It is a Sony A5100, and I've been loving the results of what I've been able to do with it. Now this particular video, I have it hooked up HDMI to a video capture cards, so I don't have to mix the audio and the video together, but it ends up being 30 frames a second. But I got the cheapest video capture card I could. The photos that I've been taking, the night shots, just... I'm doing things that I've wanted to do with a camera for 20 years, you know? And that's been keeping my spirits up a lot. I am paying rent here. I'm not just mooching off my mom, but then people will say, well, you're mooching off the government. Well, you know, I haven't been able to keep work. I still have those issues that come up once in a while where someone will say something, it catches me off guard, and then I lose my speech center. Just poof, gone. I can write, but I can't speak. And that's the sort of thing that got me, that messed up my work the most when I was trying to work. So I'm on disability income, staying at my mother's, paying rent. It's hard to have much of a self-esteem with some of those elements. If I can figure out a way to make this room really quiet somehow, or maybe have the microphone in the next room or something like that, I can maybe start working on voiceovers. Go to voice123.com or something like that. Maybe try to make some more money. But you can only make a very limited amount of money if you're on disability or you lose your disability. The income, I mean. You lose the disability income. So, you know, I'm thankful for what I have, but I sure don't have that great of a self-esteem right now. When I was saying in the beginning, you know, how I put far too much importance on my appearance, you know, When this whole downward spiral really started is when I had to shave off the purple. That's when it started. I was doing really well before then. But then that happened, and it's just... So... One thing I've got to say, though, is that I may have lost a number of online friends, particularly gay friends, from my being honest about a lot of this stuff lately. I've also gained a number of followers and people that have been so incredibly supportive, and... You know, whether you agree with me or you don't agree with me, or you're indifferent but you're still supportive, you have no idea how much you've helped me. You have no idea how much you've helped me. You have really been keeping these suicidal ideations at bay, and I really want to thank you for it. I also want to apologize to those this week that I have not treated that great. When I am feeling this low, I will sometimes lash out. And I'm sorry.